war's end stole the headlines. Not a single soldier had been seen during the entire war. So where did all these troops come from? Operation Welcome Home tried to put a human face on the war, but it was too late for George Herbert Walker Bush.
It's a proud day for America, and by God, we've kicked Vietnam syndrome once and for all. Thank you very, very much.
Bush won the war, but lost the election 9 months later. There were no heroic images of victory to use in his campaign. The next war would have pictures. This looks like war, but these aren't soldiers. They're reporters training for the Pentagon's new concept for the press. Embedded journalists. It works like this. The Army requires journalists to sign a contract that sets rules for their reporting. The Army assigns them a unit. They have no choice. If they leave, they can't come back. They see and report war from the American point of view. A simple contract incorporates the media into the military.
The embed process was both the result of pressure from the media to have greater access, lack of satisfaction in the political establishment about the benefits of the Gulf War. You remember in the presidential campaign afterwards, George Bush Sr. had no great victory to show the American people because there had been no reportage from there. And finally, I think it was clearly a decision in the Pentagon to give the give reporters and camera people more freedom at the same time having them under your control.
Once you become dependent on them for everything in that very controlled way, once you're embedded, you are imprisoned in a certain way. And at the same time, they're saying to you, put your cameras on our tanks, we're going to show you pictures you never would have gotten without us. And they're right, by the way.
From ABC News,
if the Pentagon was determined to do better this time with embeds and new technology, so was American television. Gulf War 1, Take 2. War in Iraq.
On World News Tonight, Saddam Hussein...
War with Iraq, when it matters most.
The graphics were better, the music was better. Television war plunged into the world of virtual reality.
America at War. John Roberts and Byron Pitts with the Marines. Jim Axelrod with the 3rd Infantry Division. Mark Strassman with the 101st Airborne.
The first Gulf War was live, but without pictures. This war would have almost every image imaginable.
Northern Iraq. War coverage from the front lines. Experience CBS News.